Hello gaming friends and welcome to a new video. And this time I'm going to do something completely different. I will be playing games that are enhanced for the Xbox One X and talking about what is improved and what could have been improved. But you don't hear me complain because all these updates are so far for free. And I'm going to talk about some messages that I've been get in the previous Xbox One X video when I did the review of the console. I will start up this game because, well, this game really blew me away because I knew that it also had a 3D mode in it. I tried it out and it was amazing to say the least. I show you, of course, now also the startup time, the loading times, which are just like all the Xbox 360 backwards compatible games, very fast. So, there it is. Oh, I can even skip this. I never knew this, so that was not even loading time. Wow, okay. Next time I will try how quickly I can skip this. As you can see, it starts up almost immediately. I will start off again from the beginning. New. And I'm talking, so let's do it very easy. I've seen this part in 3D and now I'm playing it, of course, normally because otherwise my phone can't capture it. First of all, the color use and how sharp it is. It's amazing that they have been giving an Xbox 360 game the 4K treatment. And the first impression is, wow. Of course, compared to an Xbox One game, look at the shoulders. You can see that it's been created out of a less amount of polygons that the Xbox One X would have done, or the normal Xbox. But seeing this game being given to us in 4K, and the performance, the part that I've been playing so far, has been going very, very smoothly. And also on the 360, you could play this game in 3D, but since the resolution was so low and it went so blocky, it was just so much uglier than playing the game in normal mode like this, that I never actually taken the time to play through the whole career mode in 3D, which I am going to do on the Xbox One X, because also in 3D mode, it's super sharp. Amazing. I will not play a long time because I want to talk to you guys about other things as well. But this was amazing in 3D, with all the particles flying around. For such an old game, it still looks and plays amazing. No frame drops, everything is just perfect. Wow. And even doing this not in 3D is cool. Oh, I need to take cover. Yeah, I don't play shooting games that much, but Gears of War is one of my favorite series because you can play it on easy and still live through the whole story experience. And this is just like a popcorn movie, not a very deep story, or let me say, you don't have to use your brain that much. That's what I refer as a popcorn movie. Yes, truly wonderful, magnificent. Well, before I shut down this game, I will talk about the very first message, and it's actually kind of a recent message about somebody who is worried about how strong or how long the Xbox One X will last. For just about every console that is getting a release, you get to see those videos that it fails, and a Switch has already bending problems. And also a problem with the, if I'm not mistaken, left Joy-Con getting out of sync, such problems. The PlayStation 4 has overheating problems. Well, by coincidence, my PlayStation 4 has the same problem, even though it has no dust in it. But I will just replace it with a PlayStation 4 Pro instead of letting it getting fixed. So I have a new premium console to hook up to my television. But, so he was worried about the longevity of the Xbox One X. Of course, it is too early in its time to say how long it will last. But since I'm having overheating problems with the PlayStation 4, I am always checking my Xbox One X if I turn it off after a long playing session. And, yeah, I focus on the game and on the talking, so sometimes there will be an awkward pause in there, but...
It's okay.
But so far, I never felt that the Xbox One, even if I play a game that is very demanding on the system, because well, this is just a 360 game, so I guess it's more easy for the console to play this than to play an Xbox One enhanced game in 4K. But so far, no matter the temperature in my home, the temperature of the Xbox One X is really, really low. And to be honest, I've heard some people saying that they could hear because of the sound it makes, which I haven't heard yet when I'm sitting in front of it, that you can hear how hard it's been working. Then I think my Xbox One X is falling asleep and still doesn't think it's being challenged. In the meantime, you can see the wonderful graphics of this game. It truly looks amazing. Well, I also promised to... But before I dive into what I would like to see changed, well, no, you will see it right here. There are a few blurry textures in the game. Main characters get, of course, a better treatment than side characters. And sometimes when they get up close, it's quite noticeable. But on the whole, the presentation of this 360 game is amazing. It's that I've already owned all the Xbox games and that I knew that this was a 360 game. If I haven't known this, I would even maybe fall for somebody saying, well, this is an Xbox One X game. I could have believed it. So colorful. And even though this is not in HDR, it still looks amazing.
Out of mind.
Some scenes in this game are actually videos instead of in-game graphics, and since, well, on the 360, the balance between in-game and the videos is not that big. But on the Xbox One X, since this game is enhanced so much, that when you check this game, oh, let me see where I need to go. Oh, I don't get any answers where to go. Oh, yeah. Since the difference is a night and day, when you go back to the video, which they didn't enhance, it's really like a... that just stands out too much. It's actually rather ugly to see after watching this wonderful image quality. Okay, back to the topic. Me and my nephew, we have our Xbox One X on launch day. On Avard, after work, I play or use it as a Blu-ray or 4K Blu-ray player for, say, between 2.5 to 3.5 hours, so say 3 hours in Avard. On a weekday, the Xbox One X is getting used. In the weekend, it's on almost all the day, except for when I'm doing shopping or when I play my keyboard and make a music video. But normally, the Xbox One X is in the weekend on a Saturday or a Sunday on for at least 5 or 6 hours, sometimes even longer. And it never overheats, and so far it never crashed on me or I found another malfunction. In other words, no problems to report here. I think it's too early to panic, because you've seen one or two or three or whatever amount of videos of Xbox One X failing on us. When actual news sites are reporting problems with the X, then it's time to worry and, well, let's hope we don't have to send back our consoles. But, well, judging from, for instance, the build of the normal Xbox One, compare it to this 360, which had the Red Ring of Death, the normal Xbox One was built so solidly. Yeah, it looks like a very old VCR, old school. The design wasn't pretty. But other than that, amazing, amazing game. Amazing game console, I mean. Yeah, I've lost my train of thought because I was also thinking about what am I going to show you next. What I'm going to show you next is a game that hasn't been enhanced. But like I said in the review, due to the faster loading times, it really is a feast to return to this game. I've already played through the story mode again from start to finish. And due to the faster loading times, you play more than you are waiting. And I don't know how to explain this, but I've read on a website that some games get different improvements. And this game, for instance, seemed to have a better construction of how the textures are being loaded in. For instance, the textures of the road, the white stripes, that the further away the textures are, the lower the quality, and this to save memory. But somehow it looks like the textures are being made sharper in the distance as they were on the normal Xbox One version. Unfortunately, I am not in possession of my original Xbox One anymore. I gave that away to a friend. But I've played this game so much, there are so many hours of gameplay in this game, that I can tell you that I'll see a difference, a big difference. The colors are much warmer. Let's just display, put away my weapon, because I am going to show you something about the loading times. The flight school, as you still may remember, there's also a mission where you have to attend to flight school as Michael. When you play that mission, when Trevor was preparing a heist, when he moved to Los Santos, and he said to Michael, you gotta get flying lessons, otherwise I get angry if you fail to do so and the heist would go wrong. What I noticed when replaying the game on the X, I noticed the loading time has been improved much. This game hasn't got much loading times in the story mode at all. But what I notice is when you finish one of the objectives, then the load time between the next objective is almost instantaneously compared to when I was playing on my original Xbox. Normally, I will tell you right now when it's in the... Oh, never mind. Yes, you can save. When you get to see what medal you get in the training, see, I'm immediately back at selecting the next thing. Usually you get to see what medal you earned. And right now it's like I select the next thing and it's immediately playing again. Usually I'll have to wait until I can do another lesson. Let's skip this. Oh no, I'm playing already. Oh wow! Yeah. It's really amazing. Also, the colors pop on my new television combined with the excellent improvements that the Xbox One gives. Oh, I oversteered a bit. But I'm focusing more on making the video and talking about the game than on how good I am playing. It's amazing to see how quickly the loading times are. This is the very short loading time. Look, you get to see immediately what medal you got. And while the medal is being shown, you are thrown back into the menu already. on the normal Xbox One, you get to see a blue loading screen, and while it shows the medal that you've been given for the performance, and then it will take you to this menu. And now it's instantaneously, when you finish your flying lesson, you will be thrown back into this part of the game. And if you want to quit the flight school, yes, because the rest of the talking I will do while driving, so I can focus on talking instead of in flying and having to pass the missions. So, because, in this game now you can see the loading times are better, I can tell you that the color definition is better, and also the sharpness of the textures. For instance, those white lines, unfortunately it's night at the moment, but what I will do while I'm talking about what I see as an improvement, I will go to his house and then I will save a few times until it's daylight again, and then I can show you this better, because I think the iPhone will not pick up the sharpness in the distance in the dark. Oh, I need to go over there. So, the sharpness of the textures are better. Yeah, for me it's a new experience, and this is a game that didn't receive a patch at all. Like I said in the review, so even without a patch, a lot of your games are giving you a better gaming experience right out of the box without an update. This makes me a happy gamer and very satisfied with my Xbox One X. And like I said, so far I haven't got any problems at all with it. It doesn't get too hot. Another thing that I really like about it, well, usually when I watch my movies, I've got me the PlayStation 3, which has a very quick startup time, and it has a very nice and expensive monster HDMI cable for the best screen quality possible. So this is my Blu-ray player to go to when I'm playing my Blu-ray movies or 3D Blu-ray movies. Of course, it doesn't support 4K Blu-ray movies, but, well, that's where the Xbox One X steps in. Well, what was the case? This weekend, I was very curious how well Toy Story 1, 2 and 3 on Blu-ray would look on the PlayStation 3 on my new television. And when I was checking the movie, I noticed some, how can I say it? It's like movie grain in the sky when you got a blue sky and it's supposed to be evenly blue, so no poor spots in there, no darker blue spots or so. I don't know how to actually explain this in English, but I think you know what I mean. But then I thought, you know what? I am going to try watching the movie on the Xbox One X to see if the more modern structure of the console will help improve video gameplay or movie gameplay. And let me tell you, yeah, it got the same expensive monster cable on the Xbox One X. Oh, I forgot to go a little bit further. It got the same cable as my PlayStation 3 has, except for 4K movies, because I guess this will have a much higher data bandwidth than the normal Blu-ray movies. And so I bought me a soothing cable for the Xbox One X. And yes, the image quality has improved playing the movie back on my Xbox One X. Almost when you step very close to the screen, you can still notice a little bit of those darker blue spots, or I don't know how to actually call it. But just sitting watching the movie from a normal viewing distance, I didn't notice it anymore, and so for me it's perfect. Yeah, amazing console, having the time of my life with it. At the moment I'm trying to remember some more comments, because my gaming channel isn't that popular, and it hasn't been growing at all or super slow. My music channel was more popular, But since my very first Xbox One X video, it's amazing to see how many of you new subscribers subscribe to my channel. So it's nice to hear that sometimes I get stuck on my words because all my videos that I'm making are not prepared. They are just, I feel like making a video talking about games and share my opinion on this new console with you guys. And I will do some other consoles as well, but at the moment the X is getting the love because I truly love the system the most. Yeah, the comfortable controller, the improvements on my multi-platform games, the faster loading times because I'm here to play games and not wait to play the games. Yeah, nice that you can just save and then it's daylight again. The phone has already a great camera and will show you a good amount of detail, and I hope you get to notice this as well. That, well, you can see that the draw distance of the high quality textures, it looks as if it's further away. The only thing that still pops up, and this is why I still am hoping that Rockstar is still going to make a 4K patch for the Xbox One X, that is the shadows. The shadows are still popping up far too close, especially when you are on the freeway, which I am going to right now. Well, this yellow line in the middle of the road, usually you get to see it blurry far away. But now the texture improvements are happening much further away than it usually would. So, yeah, the game already looks sharper without the enhancements. I will just go on this, yeah, unconventional way on the freeway. Let's see, do we get shadows? No, not on this side of the wall. Maybe the sun is on the wrong side because I see that the shadow is on the left of my car. So let's drive the other way around and see if we have shadow on this part. Yes, I don't know if my phone will show it, but right here you get to see the sharp textures of the shadow, and here it's blurry. So not that far away from my car. And this is what I'm hoping that Rockstar will improve with a patch. Especially when you play online those driving modes and you drive high above the floor and they make a raceway in the sky and you're looking down, you get to see the shadows of that raceway on the real world of GTA. But also those shadows, they are either popping in very abruptly or they are very blurry, and then suddenly when they are getting close, pop, and it's very sharp. And that's the only thing that kind of takes away, yeah, the immersive graphics that pulls you into this very realistic world. And this is not even the PC version, which already has a nice modification that you get real life colors. It almost looks like a movie of someone driving through Los Angeles, or in this game, Los Santos. But still, with the improvements that we are getting already without the updates, it's amazing to see what the game has turned into. Okay, next. So Rockstar, if you're hearing this, this game is still getting played a lot. And as a matter of fact, the 12th of August, we get an update with a new online heist again, with a new car, which I really want to buy. I've been playing this game online for a few days like crazy to save up for that James Bond car that can fly and go underwater. Man, I'm looking forward to play this. But I am also looking forward for a patch to improve this game. I don't even need 4K. I would even be happy if the resolution stayed the same. But even less texture improvement that's visible. It would be nice if it's being constructed even further away. And what I showed you pointed out that how the shadows are being drawn onto the screen. It would be nice if that was further away as well. So adapt some PC settings and make it compatible with the Xbox One X. And maybe with other games you get to choose what you want to play and in what kind of performance enhancement you want. Well, this game also has much quicker loading times. No patch. This is not Xbox One X enhanced. But also this game is improved by the Xbox One X. Of course, the loading times, they are very snappy. Again, well, that's quite logic because Xbox 360 games, especially when they don't have 4K textures being given to them, they are, of course, not as big. And this was an Xbox Live Arcade game, so they were never big to begin with. But still, the graphics looks a bit smoother, as if the Xbox One X is trying to mask the jagginess of the game because the resolution is so low. And you know what? It works. The effect works for me. Also, the lighting effects when you are in the elevator. Start game. Let's load the game. Because I've tried out this game already before I made this video. So you don't have to wait because it needs to download the save game from the cloud. Because of course I swapped my Xbox One for an Xbox One X. So I wanted to see how well the game played, and it was amazing. And also here, the colors are much deeper, the red really pops out, and even though this is a 360 game, you will see jaggies in here. So on some colors, it's very noticeable that it's a lower resolution game. But in this red part, due to the use of the color, and it looks a bit more smoother over there. As well as the textures on the floor, they look smoother. Even if you turn around, so the lines are not perfectly horizontal, because then it's easier and you don't notice the jaggies that much. Oh, I really love this game. I've been finishing this game for such a long time. Oh, we gotta be over there. That's easy. And then I make a hole over there. I turn around and there's my cube. Oh, I can play this game all day. Amazing. I kind of forgot my train of thought where I need to go, but yes, it's here. And this will be a hole. Thank you very much. And in the elevator where the loading occurs, when the elevator moves up or down, you get to see a lighting effect going over the door. This looks much better on the X as well compared to on the normal Xbox One and of course the 360. But like I said, this game hasn't been given a patch. And still you get better color depth, you get that improvement in quality. I thought I did something wrong, but no, I did it properly. I aimed the portal at the right place. I will not play this too long, because if I dive into this game, I can play for hours until I reach the end. So lately, usually I don't even need to save. I just plow through the game in one go. I truly love it. It's still, of course, I know the story by head, of course, now by memory. No, and if I'm not talking about things... that's where to go. And then when it's over there. Yes, and now I shoot a portal over there. Oh, I shoot the portal not in the proper position. Now it's better.
Oh, oops, too early, but maybe I can... Yes, I can jump on it.
Oh man, the difference in is night and day when the texture is. There's much more depth in where it's dark and where it's light. Of course, this also has to do with the fact that I've got a better TV. But rest assured, I bought this television in the summer. And from summer, at the beginning of the summer, till when this console was released, I also played my Xbox on the same quality TV. And yes, I still notice a huge difference in graphics, color. It's amazing how they've done this. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, when I solve this room, I will go to the next game and then I will end the video. Or never mind. I will not go to the next game because I see I'm already talking for like an half an hour and I don't want to bore you for too long, and I will make a new video when I have the time. Because look, I can play and talk about games all day long. But I know when I'm watching a movie or a video on YouTube from one of my friends or the big channels, because I like following the big channels for the information, because they usually get their information first. But I prefer watching the smaller channels, like not myself, of course, because why would I want to watch myself? But I prefer the smaller channels because they are gamers and not somebody who needs to make money with their... Oh, I forgot what to do. Never mind, I need to be here. And then I need to shoot a portal over there.
The Enrichment Center apologizes for this huge broken...
Okay, I will shut this game down because I need to think... What to do, and then talking about games and talking, well, to round up the movie. I thought I already put the thing over there. Oh, I went to the wrong side. Never mind. Oh man, well, this proves I can't talk and play at the same time. Okay, when it's over there, it will have been saved, I guess. Or no, I have to save myself manual. That's true. It also has an autosave feature, but I prefer to create my own save game. Well, as you can see, loading time, loading bar, bloop, and it's full, and there we go again. Save game. Okay, I don't know what I was talking about, but I will end it right here because it's really taking a long time. Oh yes, I know what I was talking about. Smaller channels that I was preferring to watch. Because like me, all you smaller video game YouTube sites, you are gamers and you also play the game for a hobby and not to make money with your channel. It would be nice if I could make a living out of my hobby, either my music, either my gaming, or both. That doesn't matter. But at the moment, I do not need the income from YouTube or whatever source to get a living. So, yeah, I'm not that eager to... And I also like the honesty of the gamers that actually are talking about the games. It doesn't feel like somebody who's been playing the game for hours and then perfectly talks about like the game as if it was a commercial, that you're just talking ad hoc, just, oh look, let's do a video and then play. I can hear and see when somebody is really genuinely enjoying his gaming experience, instead of he's got a great talking voice and is making a living out of it. Of course, there's the combination between the two as well. The one springing to mind is Jake Baldino. I kind of forget the YouTube channel. He's got a real nice voice to listen to. And he likes gaming. And there are a few big channels that also has this. But also a lot of channels doesn't have this. Before I end the video, this is really the final part that I'm going to talk about. And that is, there's some big channels that even has game journalists that can't play. Okay, let's go back in time. And then I'm talking about the time when Outrun 2 came out in the arcades. I was blown away by the graphics and it was running on, well, improved normal Xbox hardware, but with more memory and the game being on ROM instead of on a CD-ROM. So no loading times. But then I got word through the internet and through the magazines that I read that Outrun 2 would come on the normal Xbox. So I was happy. And then finally I get to see some videos on YouTube. Some game journalists played the game and the very first thing that I thought, oh man, the developer Sega handed out the game to Sumo Digital, did the game. And for me, it was the first time that they did a Sega game. And I saw somebody playing Outrun 2 on the Xbox. And I thought, the gameplay is broken. He was more off the road than on the road. It was, the steering just looked terrible. And then my friend, my nephew, I mean, he had the demo of this game. So I went to his house and I played the demo myself. I was like, what the? It's exactly like the arcade. It's smooth. The drifting works the same, except for when you play with a controller instead of a steering wheel. But I could play the game smooth and good from the get-go. Of course, I improved my racing times and racing lines after you get used to the controller. But I felt it was good. So the few videos that I saw, other people playing the game, they suck. And so this is why I prefer to watch the smaller channels, because they are genuine gamers, really liking to play the game. And then I get a much better idea if that game that he is playing would be something for me. And that's it for now. I hope I didn't bore you to sleep. And I hope you're having a great festive season. Enjoy gaming some more when you got some more free time. And until we meet again on the next video. Goodbye.